Today, August 13, 1966, the state police have arrested the alleged serial killer calling himself the Artist. He kidnapped his first victim 15 years ago, a young girl, kicking off a chain of murders in the years since. His real name is unknown at this time. Officer Dana Strange arrived on the scene first, and we're being told she's the one who made the arrest. Police have yet to determine the exact number of victims.
Never forget that day. It was 1951. We were playing at the ranch when some bees attacked, so we ran into the corn to hide. If I'd known what was waiting in the corn, I would have dealt with the bee stings instead. It's been 15 years since the day my sister disappeared, the day I promised I'd become a detective and find her. Ursula? Ursula! It's me, sis! It's Dana! I'm here! Hang on, honey! Please, hang on! Ursula?
Finally, genuine happiness and despair. I've wanted to capture these emotions for so long, even if it cost a life. It's perfect.
You! You're under arrest. My sister disappeared that afternoon in the cornfield, but I knew she didn't wander off. She was kidnapped. So I went to the academy to learn everything I needed to know to find my sister and her kidnapper. I started my investigation as soon as I could, and eventually picked up the long and bloody trail of a serial killer named the Artist.
Come on, Dana. I know you're home. Talk to me. I'm not leaving until you do.
Mal, what are you doing here?
It's good to see you, Dana. Look, I heard about your sister. I'm so sorry, but I need your help. I opened a private detective agency, and I could really use your help. It'll be just like the old days. I even have the first case for you. Isabella Arquette is a student at the College of Art. She's been helping me design my office, but she didn't show up today. I don't think it's serious, but I'm too busy to check up on her. If it helps, she always carries a fancy name brand bag with her. What do you say?
Isabella isn't at the college, but her roommate said she'd recently helped with some new film project at Vintage Cinema. That's strange. More of those bees.
What are you doing here? The theater is closed.
My name is Dana Strange. I'm looking for Isabella Arquette. I'm told I might find her here.
The art student? She's been helping me with a project. She was here this morning, but she left at noon. Is she all right? A strange guy was hanging around and asking about Isabella. He was really weird. Sorry, but that's all I remember. I have an interview any minute now, anyway.
Officer Strange, Freddie Blackbird, Rainville Times. I'm a big fan. I followed your investigation of the artist from the very beginning. I want to interview you later, but I have a meeting with Mr. Sheen right now. It's confidential, of course.
That must be the reporter that got in my way the day we arrested the artist. What a pest. I'll stick around and see if the guy who was looking for Isabella comes back. That's Isabella's purse.
Thank you.
Is that Isabella? She isn't running away.
You dropped your bag at the movie theater, Isabella. See? I care about you. So please, stop avoiding me.
He's acting so weird. What did he give her? And why isn't she moving? I have to save her. I'm sure I have the right guy. But I don't have solid evidence that he kidnapped her. I need to catch him red-handed. I've met a few maniacs in my time, but hopefully this one hasn't hurt anyone yet. I need to sneak inside to avoid scaring him off.
Ursula? What? What are you doing here?
No, I... Look, my name's Eve. You're Miss Strange, right? You're all over the tabloids for your work on that case with that artist guy. Are you chasing someone new? Well, just between us, the Thompson kid clearly has maniac potential. Get a close look at him. Sorry, I gotta go. I hoped Mr. Thompson was around, but he's away. It's been a pleasure, Miss Strange. In fact, here, I want you to have this.
Who was that? Someone pushed me. Stay where you are! It's time I tell Malcolm that Isabella is in trouble.
You've reached Nelson Investigations. We can't answer the phone right now. Please, call back later.
Where could he be? I guess I'm on my own here, as usual.
Who are you? What do you want? I don't have any money.
I'm not robbing you, Jack. I'm looking for Isabella Arquette. I saw you escape with her purse, and it was covered in blood.
I don't know what you're talking about.
This will be easier if you admit it, Jack. You kidnapped Isabella to make her love you.
No, you don't understand. It's that man. He said he would help me talk to Isabella. I went to the movie theater, but all I found was her purse and some blood.
What man?
Mr. Sheen, the owner of Vintage Cinema.
Someone used Jack's obsession to put me on the wrong track. Jack was looking for Isabella too, but he only found blood, fear, and despair. Isabella's been in danger the whole time I was barking up the wrong tree, but at least I know where to search now. The artist's legacy ends today.
Thank you.
They must have kept Isabella here. I need to find her before it's too late.
The artist is an unrecognized genius. His films are true art. Screening these films will immortalize his name and mine for all time. Poor Isabella doesn't suspect that you'll soon become a part of history itself. It's easy to elicit fear. You only need to point a loaded gun at someone. Just remember to shoot the scene to capture the moment on film. Isabella lived up to my expectations. It's harder to get despair and joy. It's taken me a month to understand how the artist got these emotions. The subject must realize that they have no chance, and only at the last moment see a glimmer of hope.
handcuffs would come in handy.
Take mine. I heard a noise up here and came up to check it out. Keep an eye on him. I'll go to the car and call for backup.
Dana, are you okay? I came as fast as I could.
I'm fine, Mal. I'm glad that officer called for backup. I didn't expect such a quick response.
What officer? There are no police cars in this neighborhood. I'm the one who called for backup. Jack Thompson called me and told me everything.
Jack? How did he find you?
It turns out he's been keeping an eye on Isabella for a while, so he knew she was working for me.
Hey, we solved our first case. Let's celebrate by calling our detective agency Strange Investigations. What do you say? By the way, Dana, do you always sneak handcuffs into the movies? Most people just go with candy.
How do you like this? Two detectives with high-profile arrests and stellar records. Out of work! Maybe we need to advertise.
Is this Strange Investigations? I hope you can help me. My name's Denzel Freeman, and I own a grocery store. This will sound strange, but a headless ghost keeps robbing my store. And the police just laughed at me.
I don't believe in ghosts, Mr. Freeman. But I'll take the case. I'm sure we'll be able to find a logical explanation for this. Right, Mal?
We're happy to help you, Mr. Freeman. Dana, please accompany him to the store and take a look around. I'm going to take care of advertising.
I've already tried so much to drive the ghost away. I called a priest, a psychic. I even tried voodoo. It was all in vain. The ghost keeps coming back. It's turning my hair gray.
I hope you have a better idea, Miss Strange. There's a magnifying glass tied to the counter that might help. Here, you'll need this.
But the key.
You're under arrest.
Tell me you also saw it, and I'm not crazy.
All of the pieces are finally coming together. As I suspected, this is not a ghost. Rollers with an inertial mechanism, that's how the ghost seemed to glide around. All of the pieces are finally coming together. As I suspected, this is not a ghost.
Thanks for your help with the wheel. I don't have any money, but I can give you this. Can I help you with something else?
Yes, a strange passenger got on your bus. Did you see where he went? He was, well, headless.
Someone ran towards the thicket as soon as I opened the doors, but I didn't think to check if they had a head or not. Either way, I didn't chase him. They don't pay me enough for that.
You also.
I guess.
Mr.